Verdun law states that in the long run, productivity generally grows proportionally to the square root of output. As a result, in the presence of increasing returns, faster growth in output results in faster growth productivity. It is named after Dutch economist P.J. Verdun, who published it in his paper in 1949. He measured the impact of economic growth on labor productivity growth in manufacturing for a group of countries in the late 19th century and early 20th century. In general terms, Verdun's law implies the existence of a stable and positive causal relationship from the growth rate of output to the growth rate of productivity in manufacturing in the long run. Let P and Q represent the growth rates of labor productivity and output in manufacturing measured in logarithmic terms. Verdun's law was originally estimated as P is equal to A plus BQ, where B is a positive parameter that measures the elasticity of labor productivity to output. The estimate of B, known as the Verdun coefficient, in most empirical studies takes a value around 0.5. The intuitive meaning of this result is that the additional 1 percentage point increase in the growth rate of output leads to a half percentage point increase in productivity in manufacturing. Since P is equal to Q minus N, where N is the growth rate of employment in manufacturing, Verdun's law can also be estimated as N is equal to minus A plus 1 minus B into Q. Productivity growth is the key to economic development in any society. The continuous increase in labor productivity is what allows human societies to experience a rise in their per capita income, even in the face of a growing population. Productivity growth is usually associated with technological innovations, but since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, it became clear to social scientists that economic growth itself may foster productivity growth through the division of labor, as pointed out by Adam Smith in 1776. However, despite the direct evidence that productivity rises with the level of output in manufacturing, the concept of increasing returns was ignored through most of the 19th century in the mainstream economic literature. The importance of increasing returns for economic growth was revitalized by Alan A. Young in 1928. He emphasized that there's a reduction in the average cost production when there's an output growth, and also that product diversification characterizes an increase in the division of labor. Verdun's law attempts to quantify this relationship. The theoretical foundation of Verdun's law is the existence of economies of scale in manufacturing, that the average cost of production falls with an increase in the amount of the goods produced. The sources of economies of scale within a firm or industry are usually divided into two categories, static or dynamic. Static economies of scale come from the fact that most processes of production incur a fixed cost, that is, a cost that has to be paid no matter whether anything is produced. As a result, the higher the level of production, the lower the average fixed cost per unit produced, and consequently the higher the economy of scale. It should be noted that static economies of scale are reversible because, if production is reduced, the average fixed cost rises. Dynamic economies of scale come from the productivity gains associated with innovations brought about by the increase in production. The intuition here is that the dynamic economies arise from learning by doing and as such are irreversible. Even if the level of production falls, the new knowledge acquired from experience does not vanish. The main economic implication of Verdun's law is that growth may be self-reinforcing, especially if we bring international trade into the analysis. The basic idea is that fast-growing economies may be able to maintain their international competitiveness because of the fast productivity growth induced by income growth itself. By the same logic, slow-growing economies may not be able to break out from their situation because of the slow productivity growth induced by their very own poor growth performance. That was all for this video. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel Explified. Check out our channel for more interesting content.